Hey guys, my name is Pedrotsky, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can install plugins to your CSGO server. Now, it's pretty straightforward, but a lot of people seem to get confused about it. So first of all, you need a server that is running source mod. Now, if you are not running source mod, I've got a link to a video on below where I show you how to install source mod on your server, and source mod and meta mod. And basically, when you have both of those installed, it'll allow you to run different plugins and configurations on your CSGO server. So now, for this demonstration, we're going to be installing a plugin called Bot Improver. So this makes the stock bots act a little bit differently and sort of play a bit better, jump out of corners, etc. So what first thing we're going to do, we're going to go to our server, and we're going to go to the file manager. Now, you can also do this via FTP. It's just I'm using Pterodactyl for this demonstration. So we're going to go to CSGO. So CSGO inside of here is our root directory. And then we see we have an addons folder. So we're going to click on addons. And we're going to go to source mod. And then this is where the majority of things happen inside of source mod. So we've got a folder here called plugins, scripting, game data, configs, and translation. Those are the main folders that you're going to be dealing with when it comes to installing plugins. So I've already downloaded and extracted this plugin. Now you see here, it's got addons, source mod, game data, plugins, and scripting. So let's start with the plugins. So we got plugins here, and then we're going to go to my plugins folder here. Then we simply just need to copy it in. And now, as you see, this plugin here also has what's called game data. So it means that we need to copy this game data over. Now, if you've installed a plugin and for whatever reason it's not working and you've copied over the game data, chances are the game data is probably out of date, because that changes not all the time, but sort of once every few updates they'll mess with something and game data breaks. So there's game data, and then the last one is scripting. Now, scripting is not really necessary, but basically all scripting is, it's basically just like the code for the plugin itself. So this is, I recommend putting the scripting folders inside of the scripting the scripting files inside of the scripting folder. That way you can keep track of the plugins that you have on your server, and if you ever need to modify something in the future, it's very simple. So now that we've copied over our files for the plugin, so it was three files, one of them went inside scripting, we had scripting, game data, and plugins. Now, if you've downloaded like another plugin, there could be some other files in there as well. Just one thing that is really gonna help you out is literally just reading the thread here, because sometimes, as you see here, this one requires dhooks. So dhooks is actually an extension. So we're actually going to have to install this as well. So I guess we're going to be showing you how to install an extension too, because I don't have dhooks installed on my server. So let's go here. We're going to go source. Releases on the right hand side here. So we're going to be downloading dhooks. And then I am running source mod 1.10. So as you can see here, this is actually similar, but when we go into the folder, you'll see instead of plugins, it's extensions and game data and scripting. So let's go ahead and install that to the server now. I'm actually just gonna extract this, just make it easier. So we're going to start with the extensions. So as you can see here, we've got a .dll, which means Windows. So if you're running a Windows server, we'll use a .dll. And .so, if you're using Linux, using .so. So I'm using Linux, so we're going to be using the .so. And then the game data. This in. Then scripting. Now again, scripting is not really that important. Yeah, as you can see here, this is just a test file, so we're actually not going to have to copy that in at all. So yeah, so that's how you install an extension. Now, to make sure they're running, we're just going to restart the server. Just give that a minute. Okay, so now that it's running, we need to check that the plugin is loaded. So let's type SM plugins list, and this is going to list all of the plugins installed on the server. And as you can see here, number 9, Bot Improver is running. Now, as you saw before, it said that we needed something else called dhooks. So let's say, for example, the Bot Improver wasn't running. We can literally just type SM EXTS list for source bot extensions. And then we can see here, yeah, so we got dhooks. Like, that plugin wouldn't have loaded without dhooks, but it's just for an example. You can see here that it's loaded that extension perfectly. So a few things to troubleshoot. If the plugin doesn't load at all, so first of all, it should always say it's loaded here. If it says it's failed or it's got something underneath, like, actually, let me just remove the game data for the Bot Improver so you can see what it's going to look like if there's an issue. So let's get rid of this. Let's go to SM. Actually, let's just restart the server. It's going to be easier than loading and unloading the plugin. You can also, as well, like I just said then, I'm restarting the server instead of reloading the plugin. What I've found sometimes, you just literally have to restart the server, as just reloading the plugin will sometimes just leave something left over somewhere and it just never works properly. So yeah, the best thing to do is basically, if you're installing new plugins or extensions, to restart the server. So the server's restarted, so let's type SM plugins list again. And then see, as you can see here, it says straight away errors, Bot Improver SMS. And it says error detected in plugin startup. See error logs. So if we wanted to diagnose that, like, the very first thing I'll do is literally just double check if copied everything to the server. If everything is there, then we're going to go check out the error logs. So we're going to go File Manager, CSGO, Addons, Source Mod, and then Logs. And then we're just going to click on Errors. And it's going to tell us here. So here we go. Exception reported, unable to open botimprover.games file. So botimprover.games is, it's obviously our game data. So if we go back to the Bot Improver folder here, you can see botimprover.games. So that means the game data was not able to be detected. And that's basically just caused the plugin to not load correctly. So that's it really. The main thing is just getting yourself familiar with the source mod file, like this one here. That's basically where everything happens. So just get yourself familiar with it and just where things are, like where the .smx, which is a compiled plugin, will go in plugins, and .sp is a script, like source pawn script. That's just going to go into scripting. A translation, we're going to translations. Like, you just go around and have a look. Like, that's the best way to learn, is just see what is on the server and just going through and just making yourself familiar with it. So if, like, for me, this stuff just, it's second nature now just because I've done it so much. But you know, you can get there too. It's not hard, just you have to start doing it, and just start with one plugin at a time and just start with the simple plugins. Don't, you know, think you're going to be making some crazy server. You can always build on it over time. So just start with the small stuff. So I hope this helps you out. If you get stuck at any time, leave a comment. down below, or come and visit me on Discord. We've got a tech support channel where we can help you out with your server. And yeah, if you like the video, subscribe and like would be great. All right, thanks for watching, guys, and hope to see you in the next video.